Independence Day?
No, it's not just any Independence Day. It's our 76th Independence Day.
That's 75 years of Indian independence for those of you who are a little slow with math.
Don't be rude, Varun. See, we as a nation have completed 75th year and now we are entering in 76th year. So, and this is the reason why we all have gathered here to celebrate this auspicious day.
On that note, good morning. Respected Director Father Gerald D'Souza, sir, Principal Mrs. Pauline Priya, Vice Principal Mrs. Neha Balraj, on behalf of SJCL, I welcome you all to this day. Special appearance from Sir Father Michael. On behalf of SJCL, we welcome you, sir.
At the stroke of midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India shall awaken to freedom. With these golden words of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, India claimed her rightful independence on this day 75 years ago.
But our story of independence is not something that happened in the past. It's something that we have to fight for every day. You see, unless every last one of India's citizens have access to a quality life, we can't call that true freedom now, can we? So, today at this gathering, we shall marvel at what our forefathers did for us, and we shall strive to do the same for every last one of our brothers and sisters.
Happy Independence Day, everyone. I now invite Vimala, Mary and team to start this day with a prayer.
We pray to our eternal God to stir our minds and stimulate our hearts with a high sense of patriotism as we celebrate 75th year of independence. May this day symbolize, renew our faith in freedom, our devotion to democracy and redouble our efforts to keep a government of the people, by the people and for the people truly alive in our world.
Favor and glad to do your will. Bless our land with honorable industry, sound learning and pure manners. Save us from violence, discord and confusion, from pride and arrogance and from every evil way. Defend our liberties and fashion into one united people the multitudes brought hither out of many kindreds and tongues. Endue with the spirit of wisdom those to whom your name we entrust the authority of government, that there may be justice and peace at home, and that through obedience to your law we may show forth your praise among the nations of the earth. Watch over and protect our nation's military members and their families. Sustain them with your everlasting arms. Take into your most gracious protection our service members currently deployed. May you be their comfort and their guide as they live and walk in a foreign land. Give them reassurance that you are a shield around them and ever-present help in time of need. Grant our service members courage so that in all things they may serve without reproach. Encourage them while they also encourage one another. As they serve around the world, we ask that you guard their families and loved ones back home. Provide them with peace and surround them with love as they mourn the absence of their loved one and long for their return. May they find hope and strength in you for the trials of each new day. Be with military children who endure the difficult burden of knowing their father or mother is in harm's way for months on end. Guard these children's hearts and minds despite the loneliness and uncertainty of having a parent deployed. Fill the hearts with the oil of love, placed in the wick of single-pointed mind. Light it with the knowledge of truth and remove the darkness of ignorance around you. Just as one lamp can light many lamps, let each youth kindle this light in many hearts. In the time of prosperity, fill our hearts with the thankfulness. In the trouble of a day, do not allow your trust in you to fall. Amen.
I now, with great pride, invite our principal, Mrs. Pauline Priya, onto the stage to share with us a few words.
A very good morning to one and all gathered here. On behalf of the director, Father Gerald D'Souza SJ, Father Michael SJ, the vice principal, Dr. Sneha Balraj, the faculty, staff, and all you students of St. Joseph's College of Law, I wish you all a very happy Independence Day. As India marches into the celebration of the 76th Independence Day, I invoke you all to remind, to recollect, and recall if all fellow Indians have the opportunity to celebrate and mark this day. May we, as students of law, be called to our greater commitment, be reminded of our greater commitment to make an India a country for all. Our founding fathers, the freedom fighters, fought for an India that accommodated the dreams and aspirations of every common man. We, as citizens of our country, and as law students, are called in a very special way to remind our commitment to make our country a place that accommodates the dreams and aspirations of every fellow Indian. I welcome you all on this auspicious day, and I wish you all a happy, free India in the days to come. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for addressing us. May I now request our director, Father Gerald D'Souza, to hoist the national flag. And I invite all the dignitaries to join Father.
Share a few thoughts as we are celebrating 75th Independence Day. 75th year celebrating freedom, 75 years of democracy, 75 years of self-governance, and 75 years of equality and equity. Celebration this year, the 75th, definitely is special, and it is colorful, and it is colorful in our campus as well. And that is what the instruction from the national leaders, to make it more colorful. Every household should have a flag. That is what the instruction is being given. And that is what we are celebrating. Celebrating the freedom, celebrating democracy, and celebrating, moreover, the self-governance that we are ruling our country by ourselves. Two things should ring in the mind of every citizen as we are celebrating 75th Independence Day. One thing is we need to celebrate the heritage and the culture and the achievements that our leaders have done, and the country has continuously celebrated, and this is to remember and mark that occasion all over again. I think secondly, more important, is every Indian should dream for this country. Perhaps we had the dream, our forefathers had the dream, and I believe the dream is incomplete. As the preamble of the Constitution say, we the people. What shall we call the nation? Is it the building? Is it the roads? Is the infrastructure? No. Nation is we the people. All the people consist of our nation, and that is what we need to recognize, re-recognize, and I think we need to profoundly look into the aspect of freedom in every layer of our society. So therefore, we need to celebrate the dreams of we the people. We can dream for the people, but nothing like people themselves dreaming for them and for their country. And I think that we need to realize today and acknowledge the dreams of the common people. It is a day to be optimistic. It's a day to be very positive about our country. We can be at times very critical, or perhaps more constructive about the nation building. And we need to see things very positively and with a tremendous sense of hope. Gandhiji has said, we need to consider development when it reaches the last man in society. Man includes woman too. He did not have inclusive language then. That is what he very clearly instructed. Development is not a development of the few. When it reaches the least of the person in the society, only then we need to consider that development. He also said, there is enough in this country for man's need and not for his greed. That means there is enough resource we have in our country for everyone to have a dignified life and not for a greedy life. I think this is what we need to relive today, and we need to understand the meaning of it. Therefore, the concept of development be not be restricted to high-rise buildings and wide roads. That can be one way of thinking of development in our country. Moreover, the development should consist in the welfare of the common people. I think that is what we need to today look again in our society, and we need to celebrate. As it is said, freedom is a fruit of struggle. Freedom is a fruit of leadership. Freedom that we have today is a fruit of sacrificial leadership. We know we want to be leaders today, and many want to be leaders today without sacrifice, without pain, with only they want to have gain and no pain. And that freedom, I think, is not a long-viewed one. If you are experienced with freedom, there was a lot of sacrifice that is being done, and we need to be grateful to that. And I think we need to learn from that sacrificial leadership as we are celebrating this Independence Day. Finally, my dear students, as law students, as law-abiding citizens, let us pledge that we will build our country, build our nation in the constitutional values, the values of democracy yet to be completely realized, the value of secularism, where we can live together happily and peacefully, the equality and justice. We have gone a march a long way. Ours was not an equal society. Ours was a highly hierarchical society. where some portion of the people were completely left out. From there to move to an equal society, it has taken a long way, and I think there is a still long way to go. Finally, we need to be hopeful and committing ourselves to our nation. Once people asked Mother Teresa, there's a lot of pain in this nation, what are you going to do? You are lifting a few people and going them, giving them some consolation. That's all. That means human suffering does not stop there. Mother Teresa replied, she said, yes, true, I am very much aware of it. What I do is a very insignificant service. But she also said, my service is like a drop in the ocean. If that drop of my service does not fall to the ocean is incomplete. My dear friends, if you do not give your contribution to the nation building, our nation, your nation, and my nation will be incomplete. Let us give that drop of ours, that dream, that commitment, that leadership, and moreover, cherishing the common values together, and to make this nation complete, make our country complete. Once again, let us, with a lot of zeal, lot of commitment, and lot of dream, celebrate this 75th Independence Day, and let this not be a one-day event. Let this be our pledge, let this be our commitment throughout our life. I would like to once again wish you all well and thank all the people who are responsible to organize this program of remembering the heritage of our country, the freedom struggle, and enabling us to dream for our country. Once again, Happy Independence Day.
Thank you very much, sir, for your inspirational and motivational words.
Now, Komal, I suddenly have this urge to listen to music. Do you have any on you?
It's a good thing that we have our college call right here. Guys, the stage is yours.
Sangeeta, a first year BA LLB, to share with her with us a few words.
Good morning, everyone. When I was asked to give a speech on Independence Day, I wondered, what would I talk about? Would I copy-paste a speech and use spin bot to make it seem different? That wouldn't make sense. It's not like there's a plagiarism test for it. I needed something original, something that was common to all of us, and I did. We're all students and soon to be lawyers, the deadliest combination for any politician. Something that isn't talked a lot about is the role of us, our students, the youth in our freedom struggle, the sacrifices students made then for students now to live in a free country. Students took to the streets during the Swadeshi movement, boycotting schools and colleges. They participated in massive numbers when the Mahatma initiated the Quit India movement, successfully shutting down schools and colleges and involving themselves in the freedom movement. Bhagat Singh, the youth revolutionary freedom fighter, said, "They may kill me, but they cannot kill my ideas. They can crush my body, but they will not be able to crush my spirit." This spirit that Bhagat Singh talks about is the spirit to stand up against injustice, the spirit to be defiant against inequality, and the spirit to counter forces who are out to divide us. As students who have immense privilege to be learning the law, it is our duty to honor the students who died fighting for us, to honor and uphold our constitution in times where communalism and hate is at its peak and fraternity at its lowest. It ought to be our goal to promote inclusion and equality regardless of caste, religion, race, sex, gender, and sexual orientation in all spheres of life. In this age of fake news, intolerance, both political and cultural, we must strive to steer clear of bigotry and pseudo-intellectualism. We must encourage dissent and radical candor. Let words come out from the depths of truth. It should be our primary focus to involve ourselves in giving constructive criticism of our political economy and to uphold the fourth pillar of democracy. After all, the right to disagree, the right to dissent, and the right to speak truth to power should inhere inherently in each and every citizen of this country. George Orwell once said, and I quote, "If liberty means anything at all, it means the right to tell people what they do not want to hear." This 75th year of independence, I aspire that we use our constitutionally guaranteed rights to live up to the inheritance of our hard-won freedom and make sure that we exercise it to its fullest potential, and hope to preserve the founding ideals of a sovereign, socialist, secular, and a democratic India. I'd like to thank our director, Reverend Father Gerald D'Souza SJ, and principal, Ms. Pauline Priya, for giving me this wonderful opportunity, and also thank Gio Sir and Anne Ma'am for their continuous guidance. I'd like to conclude with a slogan by Maulana Hasrat Mohani, which was popularized by Bhagat Singh, and I quote, "Inqilab Zindabad, Satyameva Jayate." Thank you.
Thank you, Sangeeta. I now invite Ms. Premlata of second year LLB to share her views.
Google showed me many options under life stories of great freedom fighters that would make for a good speech. But I felt it would be best if I share stories of ordinary people, those moving stories which would help us to see what independent India truly means. A very good morning to one and all here. In a small village, called Karcheri in Tamil Nadu, there was a young girl who has life experience made for a compelling story. Born in a poor family with two brothers, this girl always questioned things around her. Right from why she, along with the few of her friends, were not allowed to draw water from a common well, to why her brothers also received a better shared food and clothing at home than what she received. Her education in an Adi Dravida welfare school taught her treatment that she was subjected. Her had a name, it was called discrimination. This girl had been subjected to discrimination on the around of her caste and her gender. He understood why some groups did not allow her family to participate in some common gatherings and celebration in the village. The girl was deeply disturbed by the things had happened to her family. It was writing for Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was really her attention during youth. He decided to no longer a mute spectator, but to act and be vocal against the discrimination that she was subjected to. While pursuing standard 8 standard, UN delegate visited the girl's village to document the discrimination that took place in India on grounds of caste that took place in various schools in Karcheri. Hearing about his girl, family discouraged her from speaking. They feared the village elders, the leaders of the upper caste, and their reaction to the girl's frank speech. Defying to all odds, the girl wanted her narrate openly about various caste discrimination that took place in her village. the account narrated by the girl deeply moved the UN delegates. This girl, who has not allowed to mingle freely with other girls of her village, was later invited to the United Nations in year 2019 to speak on how education can be used as a tool to uplift the members of her depressed communities. Dear friends, the story of the girl that was heard about is my story. When I returned to my village people celebrated me because I was the first girl from my village, from my community, to complete graduation, and I decided to pursue law in St. Joseph College of Law, so that many young girls and members of many community can learn from my story. Dear friends, Independent India, my constitution gives people like me to dream big, dream beyond the confinements of caste, race and gender. True independent will only be an young girl like to mean openly, freely and fiercely communicate their idea. So friends, dream big, dream better. I conclude in the words of great Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who have me his life story, that allowed to me my dream. Have your vision for me and my people. Happy Independence Day. Once again, thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Premalada. Your speech was as inspiring as you are.
Hey, Varun, are you in a mood to watch a drama?
Not really. A dance is more my thing.
But a drama is more informative.
But a dance is more fun.
Drama.
Dance.
Drama.
Okay, how about both?
What do you mean?
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for our very own KASEFL team for our dance drama.
Till our last breath remains, a fight for our freedom we all crave. Now, here comes our brothers with their swords and arms. Anger boiled them with thirst, a thirst for blood, a thirst for freedom. Their hearts sang, their eyes spoke, while their arms battered. Together we bathed in blood, together we saw the dawn, and together we sing our songs.
Chinn mein ho junoon junoon wo tum de laal
They broke the chains that the Briton casted upon us, but was blindsided by the enemy lurking in the shadows. The shadow of lust and corruption overtook our brothers once again. They stand in shame, losing their hope and their will. Our enemy they faced in the dark. Will they rise or will they fall? Before, together we stood tall against our foes. The love of a land rooted within us. Together we light our hope with such love. Make way, world, the era belongs to us. We purge our demons holding us back with our hope shining bright.
चाहे जितना जोर लगा लो, सबसे आगे हो गए हैं तू।
to an end. Or in this case, all good college assemblies must come to an end. So I invite Anne Ma'am onto the stage to deliver the vote of thanks.
Respected Director, Reverend Father Gerald D'Souza, S.J., our Principal, Ms. Pauline Freya, our Vice Principal, Dr. Sneha Balraj, Father Michael, my dear colleagues and my dear students, a very good morning to all of you. I feel honored and privileged to stand before you to propose a vote of thanks on this 76th Independence Day of our country, India. Our beloved Director, Father Reverend Gerald D'Souza S.J., has always been the backbone to our success. Thank you, Father, for being a constant motivation and inspiration. Without a young and dynamic, vibrant principal, Ms. Pauline Priya, nothing of the celebration would have happened. Thank you, ma'am, for your constant guidance and support. I'll take this opportunity to thank our dear Vice Principal, Dr. Sneha Balraj, for all her guidance and support. Thank you, my dear students, for those thought-provoking and inspiring speeches and dance performance and songs, highlighting the importance of patriotism and the role of youth in reforming our nation. Thanks to all the faculty who have worked really hard to make this celebration of 75 years of Indian independence a grand success. I also thank all the non-teaching staff who labored behind all the arrangements for this event. I extend a heartfelt thanks to all my dear students for your presence here. Above all, I thank the Almighty for giving us all an opportunity to celebrate 75 years of Indian independence. Let us all strive to be responsible citizens and the agents of change in our society. Thank you. Wishing you all a happy Independence Day. Jai Hind. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you all the dignitaries. To be here, it means a lot for you, for your presence.
And thank you, guys. So, happy Independence Day, everyone.
Happy Independence Day.